Let's pray. Father God, we want to thank you for this new day. Thank you for blessing all our dear Sunday school children, Auntie Melody and Simon Bhaiya. Lord, even as we fight this pandemic, continue to be with us each day and bless all of us. Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity when we can listen and learn from your word. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
The Son of Man came to find lost people and save them. Luke chapter 19, verse 10.
Good morning, dear children. I hope all of you are keeping well. Well, it's good to be back once again, boys. I'm sure all of you are having your puja vacation, children. Now today, the story which I'm going to share with you all is a story of a very short man. Okay? He was a very short man and his name was Zacchaeus. Okay? Now Zacchaeus is found in the Bible in chapter of Luke. Chapter 19, verse 1 to 10. Zacchaeus was a really short guy, but that didn't stop him from bullying others. Okay, now he used to bully. Though he was a very short guy, but he used to bully. In sometimes we say no, chota mircha bada jhaal he had, but he was like this. Being a tax collector, he always charged extra tax. Now what do we mean by tax? Now by tax we mean when we are living in a particular place, we have to go and give money for the electricity that we are using, for the water that we are using, that we give as a vote of thanks to the government. So Zacchaeus was like this. He was a tax collector, or he was a revenue collector. Now being a tax collector, he always charged extra tax. Now, a certain amount of money, we should give it to the government, or people of that time used to give it to Zacchaeus, but on top of that, he used to charge extra money. He used to charge extra tax. Because of this, people of Jericho disliked Zacchaeus. So they thought, why are we paying extra? What is there to pay extra? Now, Zacchaeus must have heard about Jesus. Now, Zacchaeus thought, who is this Jesus man? Okay, let's see. Now, when he heard Jesus was coming to Jericho, Zacchaeus ran out to see him. There was already a big crowd standing there. Being short, he could see over the people. He couldn't see over the people. Okay, as he was short, he couldn't see over the people, and no one would move aside for him. No one was giving space. Okay, he wanted to see Jesus, but no one was giving a proper place, or you know, or allowed him to see Jesus. Now this was their payback. So the people thought, "Acha, you charge extra tax from us. Wait, we will not let you see Jesus." Now just then, Zacchaeus saw a sycamore tree. Zacchaeus climbed up and clung to a branch that hung over the road. Okay, so you can see tree, right? Like this. Zacchaeus just went up to a tree, and the tree was just near to the road, and from that tree Zacchaeus could see Jesus. Then what happened was, he could hear cheers, he could hear a lot of loud, you know, people were rejoicing, people were so happy to see Jesus, they were shouting at the top of their voice. Then what he could hear was, he saw Jesus. Suddenly there was Jesus, he could see Jesus, and standing beneath him and looking up. Okay, Then even more astonishing was what happened next. Now after he saw Jesus, he was very happy. But if you carefully notice, children, right after this moment, the thing which had happened made Zacchaeus more happy. Jesus called him by his name. Okay? Jesus called him by his name and told him to come down as he would go to his house. So Zacchaeus never knew that Jesus knew his name. Zacchaeus was shocked. Jesus came and said, Zacchaeus, come down. I would like to go to your home or to your place. Now, being with Jesus, it touched Zacchaeus' heart. And he told Jesus that he would give half of his money to the poor and that he would return the money he had stolen, repaying the people 4 times the amount he had taken. So Zacchaeus had promised Jesus that, Jesus, you have changed my heart and I'm going to pay all the extra money that I have charged from the people of Jericho, and I will pay 4 times what I have taken. How wonderful it is. Yes, Jesus not only knew who Zacchaeus was, he called him by his name. He also knew the sin that Zacchaeus had committed in the past by stealing. And what happened? Did Jesus ignore him? Okay, you're a bad tax collector. You steal people's money. I'm not going to talk to you. No, boys. No, children, no. Jesus loved him. Jesus called out by his name, Zacchaeus, come down from the tree. I'm going to go to your house today. It touched Zacchaeus' heart, and Zacchaeus became a different man. Jesus helped him change to become a better person. Jesus knows us by our name. He's always reaching out to us with love. Will you listen and allow? The question is up to you, children. Will you listen to that call? Will you listen to Jesus' call and allow Jesus to come into your heart? It doesn't matter whether you are short, tall, big, or small, or fat, or thin. No. In Jesus' eye, we are all the same. No matter how much sin we do, Jesus still loves us. Like in Facebook, we have all the Facebook friend requests and the friends. Even Jesus, in his Facebook, in his divine Facebook, which will not end, we are all there in his friends list. And he knows our name individually. We might not know all our names in our Facebook account. How many friends do we have? But Jesus, in his Facebook account, he knows each one of our names and our deeds. So the question is up to you, children, today, that will you allow Jesus to come into your heart? Praise the Lord. Children, bye-bye for this Sunday. You all stay safe and have a lovely puja vacation and read the Word of God every day. Spend time with your parents. Be safe, boys and girls. And remember the story of Zacchaeus. And please, the question is up to you whether you are going to allow Jesus into your heart or not. Till then, I'll see you all next Sunday. Till then, stay safe. God bless. Bye-bye.
For the Lord he wanted to see, and as us pray. Heavenly Father, we know that when we meet Jesus, it will be a life-changing experience. Thank you, Jesus, for knowing our name and loving us. Amen.